Hey everyone, Chris Tex here, and today I'll be playing Meditations of a Mobile Device. I found this game on Game Jolt, and I'm looking forward to playing it. I love unique little games like this, and you can see that we're playing as a phone, so let's get into it, guys. Alright.
You are an obsolete, discarded smartphone on a metaphysical journey to find a deeper meaning in life than making selfies and texting. You have come to a massive graveyard of books to search for answers.
And I like books.
Climb the stacks of books to collect all the deep thoughts. Beware of bookworms and poor battery life.
Bookworms. Okay, I kind of assume the battery... Oh, it looks so sad. His case looks kind of bent. That's probably why. He's not a Nokia. His name is I Dunno. That's pretty great. And it's a banana on the back. Everyone loves bananas. Plenty of potassium, riboflavin. It's all good for you. Monkeys love it. That's why. And they're the geniuses that kind of open it from the opposite end.
I can picture in my mind a world without war, a world without hate, and I can picture us attacking that world, because they'd never expect it.
That was good, I like that. And I like that the guy who made this game actually had Siri, like, kind of say these lines.
Perhaps, if I am very lucky, the feeble efforts of my lifetime will someday be noticed.
Yeah.
And maybe, in some small way, they will be acknowledged as the greatest works of genius ever created by man.
Hey, that's what I think every day. I'm kidding, guys. Actually, yeah, that's one. There's the bookworm. He wasn't very happy to see me, and there was some static there. I think I lost some battery life. Let's get up here. No, no, no. No, stop it. I actually just played this, but Fraps went all weird on me, so
contrary
I had to do it again.
To what most people say, the most dangerous animal in the world is not the lion or the tiger or even the elephant. It's a shark riding on an elephant's back, just trampling and eating everything they see.
I was honestly expecting her to say humans, because we are, but I guess in that case...
It takes a big man to cry, but it takes a bigger man to laugh at that man.
I'm not sure about that one. That wasn't really funny, that was just cruel. Alright. Grown men have a right to cry at sometimes. It depends, though. I mean, if they're crying over the series finale of Breaking Bad or something, then yeah, they deserve a moment. Or Mass Effect, even. The end of Mass Effect. Yeah.
Children need encouragement.
Let's go over there.
If a kid gets an answer right, tell him it was a lucky guess. That way he develops a good lucky feeling.
Right. You know, luck actually boosts confidence quite a bit, so if you think you're lucky, you're gonna be showing it, you know? You're gonna show some moxie. And people love that.
The face of a child can say it all, especially the mouth Woo! Part of the face.
Woo! Especially the mouth part of the face. That was profound. Thank you, Siri. Is anyone expecting Cortana to completely overtake what Siri has kind of accomplished in the Apple domain? I'm looking forward to it. I love Halo.
One thing a computer can do that most humans can't is be sealed up in a cardboard box and sit in a warehouse.
Now that was good. I like that. Although AI will advance to a certain point to where it will kind of overwhelm us. And because of our human curiosity, we'll just keep going anyways, despite the fact that that'll most likely happen. Because we're curious people, we were built to be that way. So, it's completely understandable that we can kind of be idiotic at sometimes. No, okay, it's constantly running for some reason.
When you go in for a job interview, I think a good thing to ask is if they ever press charges.
Especially if you're a doctor, that'd probably be a good thing to ask. You know, especially if you're a bad doctor. If you guys haven't watched Scrubs on Netflix, you need to do it. It's a great show, it's really comedic. And it's not really serious, but it's a good use of your time. You'll love the characters. No, come on, come on. There we go.
If you go parachuting, and your parachute doesn't open, and your friends are all watching you fall, I think a funny gag would be to pretend you were swimming.
Die with grace, right? Yeah, that'd be good. Alright, I'm gonna make it, I'm gonna make it, I'm gonna make it! Ah! Woo! And that'll be my best time, too. If you guys want to check this game out, it'll be on Game Jolt. If you guys have any more recommendations for games for me to play, let me know down below. Like this video, share it with your friends, let them know that I'm here, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.